Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part two of synthetic division, and we do the following three division problems using synthetic division and check each answer. All right, we're going to use synthetic division to do this long division problem. Okay, we can do it because it's a polynomial divided by a linear polynomial. You can't have an x squared or x cubed term, it can only just be an x. So x minus 3 works. And we start by taking what we're dividing by and setting it equal to 0, which means it's 3. And that's the number we put in this little box here. See part 1 if you don't know what synthetic division is. All right, then we take the polynomial. Right? The 2x squared minus 13x plus 10. We need to make sure the exponents are in descending order. So we've got the x squared term, the x, and the constant. If you have something squared, there should be three terms. And we write the coefficients in order. So the coefficients are 2, negative 13, and 10. So we write those down next to this little box, 2, negative 13, and 10. We leave a space. We underline the entire thing. And then remember, we put this other little box here, which is going to be where the remainder ends up. Okay, so step one. We take the first coefficient and we just write it down. And then we multiply whatever's down here by what's in the box. So 2 times 3, and it goes up on this next line right here. So 2 times 3 is 6. That goes here. And then we add these two together. Negative 13 plus 6 is negative 7. And we do 3 times negative 7 now, right? So whatever we get down here, we always multiply by what's in the box and put it up in the next line under the next coefficient, right? So negative 7 times 3 is negative 21. And now we add those together. So 10 minus 21 is negative 11. That represents our remainder. And as we look to the left, that's the constant, that's the x term. So the answer is 2x minus 7. And we could either write plus a negative 11 over what we divided by, or you could put a minus a positive 11. That doesn't matter. But what we divided by, make sure you look here. Up here again, what we actually divided by was x minus 3. So that looks like that's going to be our answer. You don't want to leave it looking like this. This is just sort of a way to get the right answer. So this looks like it's the right answer, but now we want to check it. So let's check our work. Okay, how do you check? You take the quotient, the 2x minus 7. Multiply it by what you divided by and add this remainder of negative 11. So we need to do 2x minus 7 times x minus 3, add the remainder, which means subtract 11. Okay, so we could use the FOIL method here. 2x times x is 2x squared. 2x times negative 3 is negative 6x. Negative 7 times x is negative 7x. And negative 7 times negative 3 is plus 21 minus 11. And that gives us, adding all the like terms, 2x squared minus 13x plus 10. We compare that with the original polynomial up here, the 2x squared minus 13x plus 10. And yes, it worked. So that's the correct answer. All right, let's do one more. All right, here's our next problem. 3x squared plus 5 divided by x plus 2. Okay, so what do? We take this and we're going to solve for x by writing x plus 2 equals 0, so x is negative 2. That's what goes in the little box over here. And now the trick is we need to put the coefficients in order. Notice is the x squared term. This means we need to have something for the x squared term, a coefficient for the x term, and the constant. There is no x term You need to realize that the x term then is 0. So let's move this down a little. This could be written as 3x squared plus 0x plus 5. And it's important that you get all three of those coefficients. So that's what goes here. It's not going to work if you just put 3 and 5. So we have 3, 0, and 5. All right, you begin by taking the first coefficient and just bringing it down, always. We multiply that by what's in this little box up here. So 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. And then 0 plus negative 6 is negative 6. And then we multiply that by what's in the little box. So negative 6 times negative 2 is 12. Oops, I forgot to put my little remainder box here. And 5 plus 12 is 17. So these are our new, the coefficients for the new quotient. So our answer is going to be, remember that's the co that's the constant, so that's got to be the x term, right? That's the remainder. So it's going to start off with 3x. So answer, 3x minus 6 plus 17 over what you really divided by was that x plus 2. Don't put x minus 2 or just don't put negative 2. It's what you divided by x plus 2. So here is what we got for our answer. And of course we want to check it. So let's check. We take the x plus 2 times the 3x plus 6, right? Take whatever you were dividing by your new quotient, which is the 3x plus 6. X plus 2 times 3x minus 6. And we're going to add the remainder, which was 17. And we want to see if that'll give us this 3x squared plus 5. So I'm going to do the FOIL method. 3x squared minus 6x plus 6x minus 12 plus 17, which is 3x squared plus 5. It all checks out. So that's the correct answer. Let's do one more. All right, we've got 5 plus 2x squared minus 7x divided by x plus 1. All right, so we start by thinking what's going in the little box. Remember, if you set that equal to 0, you get x equals negative 1. That's what goes in the little box. And now we've got to put the coefficients in order. There's a problem here. This is not written with the highest power first down to the constant. So you have to first put this in the correct order. So we've got a 2x squared. Then you look for the x term. And there is one, so it's a negative 7x. If there wasn't, you'd put plus 0x. And then we have plus 5. Remember, if the highest degree, the highest exponent is 2, there should be 3 terms. So these are my coefficients. 2, negative 7, 5. You must put those in order. Right, so let's do it. You start by bringing down the 2, right, the first coefficient here, and that gets multiplied by what's in the little box. 2 times negative 1 is negative 2. And then we add negative 2 plus, I mean, negative 7 plus negative 2 is negative 9. Oops, again, I forgot to put that little box. Then I take the negative 9 times negative 1 is positive 9. And I've got 14 for my remainder. So if that's the remainder, this is the constant term, that's the x term. The answer looks like it's going to be 2x minus 9 plus 14 over what I divided by. Up here is what I divided by, x plus 1. And let's do a quick check. You could always put the video on pause and try this on your own. What do? We multiply the quotient, which is 2x minus 9, times what we divided by, x plus 1, and add the remainder. And we're going to see if that's going to be 5 plus 2x squared minus 7x. So we get 2x squared plus 2x minus 9x minus 9 plus 14 is 2x squared minus 7x. Let's see, plus 5. And is that the same thing as 5 plus 2x squared minus 7x? Yes, and in fact, I'd written it like that here. So it checks, and there's our answer. On the next video, we'll do some problems that are higher than the second degree. So we might have something to the third power or to the fourth power, and then eventually we'll get to problems as what if it had a coefficient in front of the x, like if you were dividing by 2x plus 1. So more fun synthetic division to come. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.